just quit that grab assing. No, you're making your mom a nervous wreck.
Hello?
I don't care if she did pull your armpit hair, Raymond. You pulled hers first.
Hello?
Hello?
Well, how'd it feel?
Hi, Roy.
Y'all all right?
Yeah, sounds like you got a little going on there.
Well, nothing a size 10 and a half in a Kona won't handle, Phil.
Oh.
I guarantee. Y'all all right?
Yeah, what's the matter?
Oh, excuse me. I've been sneezing ever since I let Sharon Jean borrow that damn horse hide chair and footstool for Mother's Day.
Oh, boy.
Off of QVC, Phil.
Yeah?
Yep, Roy and Dale was hosting last week.
Is that right?
Yep, and I guess she figured the elk antler coffee table was just too damn gaudy.
Maybe so.
Yep. Well, hell,
bless
I guess
you.
I must be allergic to it, I guess.
Yeah, sounds like it.
Just as well, though, seeing as how she's been trying to get me in that dadgum thing with her to do a little bareback riding.
Uh-oh.
So, that's my excuse, Phil. I'm going to stick with it.
God bless
I
you.
I guarantee it. So, y'all been to the fishing hole this week?
No, I hadn't had a chance. How about you?
Well, I done me a little Monday Raymond hat off. Got him a 3-day weekend from Masonic.
Really?
Yep, they closed because it's a national holiday.
What's
Phil.
That?
Well, it's Frankie Avalon's birthday.
Oh.
Yep, we took opportunity to go down there and drown some bait. Took me to a place that one of his old girlfriends, Eileen Over. You remember Eileen, don't you? She told him best place called, you ever heard of Knocked Up Bluff?
No.
Yep, it's up there around Dead Rabbit Lake. It's a pretty good spot, Phil, but you got to be careful.
Why is that?
Well, there's lots of trot lines that's been strung across there.
Oh, is that right?
Yep, so if you're going up there to Knocked Up Bluff and something gets its hooks in you,
yeah.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Okay.
Now, Tuesday, I got to go up to a beautiful private fishing resort on Indian land up there, Phil.
Really?
Yep, one of my old rodeo clown buddies, Fred Running Beaver, gets me in up there.
Is that right?
It's on Lake Dichiladanuser. Dichiladanuser. I don't know. Fred told me it means loincloth that dances.
Oh, I see.
Yep, there's some spots up there, Phil. It's so full of fish, I caught 4 bass in 5 minutes.
Wow.
One on my rod and 3 in my waders.
That's incredible.
Yep, and then yesterday afternoon, Sharon Jean and I moseyed up on one of the Fingers Heavy Petting Peninsula.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, there's 5 of them, Phil, but due to something fouling up a water, only 3 of them I let you fish on.
Oh, is that right?
Yep, of course, I had to choose the one in the middle, and weren't you know it, that was a stinky one.
Darn the luck.
Yep, I tell you though, Phil, I'm kind of glad I got to go out this week.
Why's that?
Well, I got a feeling Mama and Letitia's going to bug me till I take them down to that damn rooster day.
Oh.
Yep, I won't hardly go down there since what happened 2 years ago.
What happened?
Well, I was down there standing in line to get me a turkey leg and a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
And I was standing there in front of me where there was a woman I thought I knew from a Piggly Wiggly, Phil.
Huh.
You might know her, Trixie LaBox.
No.
A little French gal, blonde yeah. Checkout gal. There we go, the one with a long ponytail. Comes all the way down to the behind that reminds you of 2 5-pound sacks of tightly packed sugar.
Wow.
I guarantee you, S&H. So I kind of practiced her on the butt. It turned out that that weren't her at all.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, it's some yuppie fella named Ian.
Oh.
Yep, he was there from Aspen selling his arts and crafts, Phil.
Yeah.
He had a booth. He sold women's purses he made out of bull scrotum. It was tiny, 2 purses in one, Phil.
Yeah.
In the summertime, it was a duffel bag, and in the winter, it drew up to a corn purse. Multi-purpose. Needless to say, I ain't looking forward to going back here. I'm afraid old Ian might be looking for closure.
Oh, no.
Yeah, well, I better go.
Okay.
Letitia's hollering at me. Hang on.
What? No, I ain't seen your diagram, sis. Last time I saw it, Raymond was sizing it up to cover his cheese dip before he put it in the fridge.
This sounds like it's going to be a fight.
Yeah, it does.
Y'all have a good
one. Thanks for the info.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
Listen, it ain't his fault. Listen, I almost used it yesterday for a shower cap.